We're gonna calculate the put option, okay? Given that you know everything from version 3, you know D1, D2 already, okay? So you're gonna calculate ND1 and ND2. If you look at the formula for P, you don't calculate ND1, ND2, but you calculate N of negative D2 and N of negative D1. There's two ways as well. So you put the value of D1 and D2 here, and then you go to the negative table here, and then follow the similar approach. But the thing is, you already know ND1 and ND2. Now, if you want to calculate N of negative D1, N of negative D2, you just simply take 1 minus ND1. Why is that? Remember what I say in the... This is normal distribution, right? This is 0 and this is D1. So ND1 will be this range, so assume that D1 equals this. So if you want to calculate N negative D1, so let's say this is negative D1, right? So this is the area you're looking for. Because this one is normal distribution, it's symmetric, left-hand side for the same, equal to the right-hand side. So the value you're looking for here is equal to this one. So you see that this one is actually the whole thing. 1 minus ND1, you can get the value N negative D1. Okay, so you can calculate it using a shortcut slide. You calculate N negative D1 will be equal to 1 minus ND1. Right, because you already got ND1, so you can put it into this one. Okay? For N negative D2, we do the same thing. So we got N of negative D2. And for calculating P, simply put into the formula, this is K is minus RT and negative D2, right, minus S0 and negative D1. So you check, put the value into the formula. Okay? Very simple. Any question? This topic looks complicated, but actually it's very simple because we only look at how we apply the Black-Scholes multiplication model. We don't go into the detail, like what are the steps to get into the formula. That will be very complicated. So here, it's simple. We apply the formula only. Now, go to question 5. Redo question 4 without using the Black-Scholes multiplication model. Okay, question 4, we apply the Black-Scholes multiplication model to find out what is the put value. But now we do question 4, but don't use Black-Scholes multiplication model. What can we do? They give you all the information like C, P, S, K, R, T. Right now you want it ask you to calculate put. So what you can do? You use the put probability, right? Because they are the option for the same stock, same time to maturity, same exercise, right? So the put and the call should follow the put probability. So here you're gonna use the put probability where C plus K in RT will be equal to P plus S0. You have everything you want to calculate P. So you rearrange this equation. You got P equal C plus K in RT minus S0. Okay? You have the value for all the variables already. So you just put it in. So C is this much, K in RT minus S0, so it's equal 1.5. Okay. So it should be equal the same with the way we do the Black-Scholes multiplication model in version 4. Okay?